Hello, welcome back to Learn Physics. In today's topic, we are continuing with our mechanical properties of fluids. Here, in last video, we did tell our manometer and there we learned about Pascal's law also. Today, we are going to study some of the applications of this Pascal's law. Okay, so are you remembering right? What is meant by Pascal's law? Whenever there is an external pressure acts on a system, the pressure will be equally distributed in all the directions. All the points, pressure will be equally distributed. Today, we are going to study about the applications of Pascal's law. So what are the applications which we are seeing in our daily life? Applications of Pascal's law. The first one is hydraulic lift. So what is this hydraulic lift? In car servicing stations and all, you would have seen the car, in car servicing stations and all, you would have seen that car while they are washing, it will be raised with some instrument, isn't it? So what is that? That is called as hydraulic lift. For lifting the car in upward direction, whether they are using so much of pressure? No, they will be pressing at one portion at the pump and this side it will be with the, not only the car, all the heavy vehicles will be, it can push the heavy vehicles by applying a small force in at one end. How is it happening? Okay, so hydraulic lift means it will be like this. One end, it will be of small area of cross section A, okay, and the other end will be having a large area of cross section A. Here, in large area of cross section, we will keep the vehicle what is to be lifted, okay, and here we are applying a small pressure using a pump, okay. So I am applying F1 force over here. So if I am applying F1 force over there, force acting will be F1 divided by A. This will be the pressure acting in the region 1. Okay, that is P1. And here in the second region, if A is this and F2 is the force acting in this portion. Okay, so F2 will be equal to F2 by capital A. That is pressure at the second region. By Pascal's law, we know P1 will be equal to P2. If P1 is equal to P2, what we can write? F1 by A equals F2 by capital A. From here, we can write it as, what will be the force acting on the second one? That will be equal to capital A into cross multiplication into F1 divided by small letter A. So, as area of this portion decreases, what will happen? A large force will be acting on the other end. This is what happening over here. So while we are applying a force, as force increases, according to that, this also will increase. That is, see, capital A we can increase and F1 we can increase. But if we are applying a small in the force on a small area, force acting on the other side will be increasing. That is the reason here we are able to apply, lift a heavy vehicle. Okay, so this is one of the applications of Pascal's law. Okay, understood? Now, the second application is hydraulic brakes. Hydraulic brake. So, while we are applying the brake, how it is reaching to the brake, to the wheel, that's how it is able to stop the vehicle. See, while we are applying, see, this will be the piston. Here only we will be applying a it will be brake shoes, here also brake shoes, and this will be a brake lining will be there with a small spring. Okay, so while we are applying a pressure in this portion, what will happen? That pressure will be reaching to this portion and which will be applying equally to both the directions. Okay, and which will be helping this brake linings to come down. Okay, brake shoes come down and which will be resisting the force to giving a retarding motion. Okay, so while we are applying a force in this portion, what will happen? Through the brake fluid, here brake fluid will be there, brake fluid will be passing that over here through the wheels, to the wheels. This is one of the wheels. Okay, so that wheel from the brake fluid will be giving a force in both the directions, but pressure will be equally distributed. See, F is the force acting in this region. What will happen? F by A will be the pressure acting in that region. That F by A will be equally distributed. F by A is over here. Here also F by A. Here also F by A. Same pressure will be acting in these two regions and this brake shoes will come down and which will give a retarding force and which will help to stop the vehicle. Clear? So how this hydraulic lift and hydraulic brake are working? Understood? So next is streamline flow. Streamline flow of fluids. What is meant by streamline flow? Streamline flow is the velocity of each layer of fluid will be same. That means it will be at a particular point. I am considering this point A, B, C. These points I am considering for a fluid. Okay, fluid is passing through this tube A, B, and inside that I am considering three points A, B, C. So velocity of all the particles passing through that point will remain the same. Okay, so velocity of the particle moving at that particular point will remain the same. Not for a single particle, we are not telling it a same velocity. Particle as it comes to this portion, it will be having different velocity. But the velocity at a particular point will remain the same. Okay, so here one velocity and here one velocity, here one velocity. If the same particle is reaching to these points, the velocity may change. But the particle at a particular velocity, at a particular point, the velocity of the particle will remain the same and it will be flowing in layers. Such kind of motion of power flow is called as streamline flow. Okay, as the velocity is increasing, its streamline nature may vary. Okay, so that means at when then what is the next, if it is varying and coming to the next stage, what is that? That is called as turbulent flow. Turbulent flow means we can't predict. Say what, it won't be flowing in layers and at a particular point its velocity will be varying. Okay, see, sometimes it will be having one velocity V1 and after some time the velocity will be V2. So it will be varying. That is called a turbulent flow. Okay, see, in heavy rainy seasons and all, we can expect this turbulent flow. If it is very calm and quiet, it is moving, means a river flow is there, then we can say it is streamline flow. Okay, so understood, it is what is meant by turbulent flow and streamline flow. So streamline flow, velocity maximum, maximum velocity with which the fluids can move with a particular in the streamline flow. That maximum velocity with which the fluids can move in the streamline flow is called a critical velocity. So what is meant by critical velocity? The velocity, it's a barrier, it is the separation velocity, which is streamline and turbulent. In between that velocity, after that critical velocity, it will pass to turbulent flow, and before the critical velocity, it will be streamline flow. So clear, what is critical velocity? The maximum velocity with which the fluid can exist as a streamline flow. That is called as critical velocity. Clear for you? So next we are going to find out what is equation of continuity. Equation of continuity. Equation of continuity. In here, I am considering the two points A and B. Okay, mass of fluid passing through a particular point will be equal to the mass of fluid passing through the other point if it is in streamlined flow. Okay, so mass of the fluid passing through a particular point will be in unit time will be equal to mass of fluid passing through the fluid in the other point also. What will be the mass of the fluid in this point at a time delta t, and what will be the mass of fluid at a particular point B in delta t, and C, in all the points it will be same. Okay, so here I am considering going to find out the mass of the fluid passing through at the point A. How we can find out the mass of the fluid which is passing through the point A? Density equals mass by volume. Then what is mass? Mass at A equals density at A into volume at A. Okay, how we can say density at A into volume, how we can find out area into, yes, distance covered, isn't it? Area into height we can consider. So rho A into area at the point A into height, how I can find out? See how much distance it is covering in delta t time interval. Distance covered, how we can find out? Velocity at A into time interval delta t. Okay, this is the mass of the fluid at the point A. Now I am considering the point B. At point B, what is the mass of the fluid? Density of the fluid at the point B into volume of the point at the point B. Okay, then it is rho B area at B into height, or distance covered will be the best word. Instead of height, we can say distance covered. Distance covered, area into, in delta t time interval only we are considering, right? So in delta t time interval, how much distance it would have covered. So rho B into A at B into velocity at B into delta t. But we know mass of the fluid at A will be equal to mass of the fluid at B, isn't it? So here what we can do, we can equate these two. Mass at the point A will be equal to mass at the point B. So rho A, A at the point A into V at the point A into delta T will be equal to rho at the point B, A at the point B, V at the point B into delta T time interval. Delta T is cancelling. Yeah, same fluid will be flowing through the pipe, isn't it? So density also will remain the same because fluid is same only. So density will cancel. We can say A at A will be A at A into velocity at A is equal to A at B into velocity at B. That is, now if I am considering one more point C, the same way we will get, which will be equal to A at C into V at C. So what is capital A? Capital A is the area of the tube at that particular point, and V is the velocity of the fluid at that point. So equation of continuity states that area into velocity remains constant. Okay, so that means area is inversely proportional to velocity, or we can say A is inversely proportional to velocity for a liquid. What is the meaning of that? See, if the fluid is flowing through the liquid, flowing through the pipe, as area decreases, velocity will be increases. Isn't that like that only, right? While we are using the hose pipe, we know if it is through the hose pipe, water will be coming with a particular velocity. If we are trying to close the half of the portion, what will happen? See, hose pipe is like this, and water is flowing like this through this area. And if I am closing the half portion, what will happen? The other area where water is coming out, that will be coming with a more velocity, isn't it? Then so velocity, as area decreases, what will happen? Velocity is increasing. If the nozzle of the pipe is very small, we can see that velocity is, it will be coming with a more velocity. As area increases, velocity will be decreasing. As area decreases, velocity will be increasing. So that is called as equation of continuity. Clear? Next is Bernoulli's equation. It's very important, Bernoulli's equation. See here in Bernoulli's equation, in a streamline flow, I am considering a pipe like this. Okay, so here this is one end, this is the other end. This is end A and this is end B. Okay, here I am considering the portion A, B, C, D. Here I am considering the portion E, F, G, H. Here through this, it is fluid is moving and it is coming out also. Here V1 is the velocity and it is considering for a time delta T. R1 is the radius of that pipe and here in delta T time interval it is moving with the velocity V2 and R2 is the radius of that pipe of that end. Okay, so here we are going to consider find out the work done for moving the fluid from the point A to B. Work done for the streamline fluid to move from the point A to B. Work done, how we can find out work done at A? How we can find out force into displacement? Isn't it? Force, how we can find out pressure into area into displacement? Isn't it? So if P1 is the pressure at this region, P1 into A1 into, how we can find out the distance covered, velocity at that region into time, distance covered. Now what will be the work done at the point B? That will be equal to second pressure P2 A2 into V2 delta T. Okay, so I am considering area as A1 here and here area as A2. Since radius are different, area is also different. Now, what will be the work done to carry from A to B? So this much of pressure is P1 and this much of pressure is B2, P2. So what will be the total work done? Total work done will be equal to difference in pressure into, otherwise we should take work done by the system, on the system and all we should consider. So instead of that you can think this is the pressure P1 and this is the pressure P2. To move from here to here, so difference in pressure only we should calculate, isn't it? So the total work done we can consider it as, so total work done P1 A1 V1 delta T minus P2 A2 V2 delta T. So what is this A1 V1 delta T? That will be equal to the volume, isn't it? Area into distance, that is volume. Here area into distance is volume, isn't it? So we can write it as P1 delta V minus P2 delta V. Okay, it is for a small change in time interval delta T, therefore we are considering it as delta V. So we can consider it as P1 minus P2 into delta V. Okay, this is the work done. But work energy theorem, in that chapter we learned it as work done will be equal to energy. Here what will be the total energy? Here it is at a height H. See, from the ground it is at a height h1 and from the ground it is at a height h2. Then it has potential energy. Since it is moving, it has kinetic energy also. So what will be the potential energy at this portion? mgh1. So what will be the mass acting on it? What will be the mass at this portion A, B, C, D? Mass will be density into volume. Okay, so density into volume is V into GH1. And potential energy at first portion, or potential energy at A, and potential energy at B will be MGH2, that is rho VGH2. Okay, so since the volume we are considering it for small interval of time V, it is delta V we can consider. Then kinetic energy, how we can find out kinetic energy at A will be equal to half m v square. M means density into volume, rho delta V into V square. Then kinetic energy at B, that will be equal to half rho delta V into V square. Okay, so this is the total energy. Now we are going to, so we have the work done. Work done will be equal to energy. Now we are finding out the total energy. So first we can find out the total potential energy. What will be total potential energy? Rho delta V into Gs common. Then it is will be equal to total potential energy. This is H1 and this is from the ground H2. So what will be the energy, total energy at this height? H2 minus H1. So H2 minus H1. Then plus half rho delta V into V square. V1 square, here it is V1 square, here it is V2 square. So we can write it as V2 square minus V1 square. Why it is not V1 square minus V2 square? Because V2 is smaller. So it is V2 square minus V1 square. Now total energy also we got it, and work done will also we got it. So work done will be equal to total energy. So we can write it as P1 minus P2 into delta V will be equal to rho delta V G into H2 minus H1 plus half rho delta V into V2 square minus V1 square. This one, if I am rearranging delta V, delta V, delta V, everything delta V is there, we can cancel that and we will get it as P1 minus P2 equals rho G H2 minus H1 plus half rho V2 square minus V1 square. Now I am taking all the one terms together and two terms together. So minus rho G H1 and minus half rho V1 square, I am taking it to the left side. So I am getting it as P1 plus rho G H1 plus half rho V1 square equal to rho G H2 minus P2. I am taking it to the right side. It will become plus P2. P2 plus rho G H2 plus half rho V2 square. So what is this? See here, since I consider two points, I am getting it as pressure plus potential energy per unit volume. Actual potential energy is rho delta V into GH1, isn't it? So here we are getting it as rho GH1 only. Delta one is, delta V is missing. So it is the potential energy per unit volume and this is the kinetic energy per unit volume. So pressure, acting pressure and potential energy per unit volume and kinetic energy per unit volume will remain constant. That is Bernoulli's principle. The sum of pressure and potential energy per unit volume and kinetic energy of unit volume will remain constant. That is Bernoulli's principle. Okay, clear? Actually, this Bernoulli's principle, Bernoulli's equation, that is very, very important. So please learn it, because most of the question paper, that question will be coming. Okay, so work done you should find out. Work done, how we will find out? Force into displacement. Force, pressure into area. Okay, and displacement means volume into velocity into time. Okay, here potential energy we will consider, kinetic energy we will consider. Taking the sum, equating with the work done. Okay, this is how we, so P plus rho GH plus half rho V square is a constant. That is Bernoulli's equation. P plus rho GH plus half rho V square is a constant. Okay, clear? This is Bernoulli's equation. Okay, so I am winding up for today. Hope all of you understood all those things. If you like the channel, please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. Bye.